Councilman Perez. Thou shalt establish the season of the harvest of waters to the both councils, as thy refuse to let it was that time they gave it away. They go up by the mountain, and they're down by the mountain, to the place which thou hast not to them. Thou hast set a mountain that they may not pass over, that they may not again shall be earth. He sends the springs to the valley which rise above the hill. They give drink every beast of the field wild of, thou much their turf. By them shall be fowls of the habit have their habitation, sin on the ground. He waters the hills from the chamber, the earth satisfied with the fruit of thy work. Cows to grass grow from cows, and herbs to the servants of man. That he may bring forth food out of the earth, plant and make glad the heart of man. And oil to make his face shine, and grab his strength from that heart. He who glory for the south, and see the sun, which he has had, where the birds make their nests, before the storm, and her feet are on his house. The high hills are a refuge for the wild goats, and the rocks from its coming. He points the moon for seeds, and the sun knows it's going down. Thou make us a darkness in the night, wherein all beasts and horses do creep forth. The unlike for us, their cry is secret, is from God. The sun arises, the gathers himself, and lays them down to their death. Man goes forth unto his work, his labor is made easy. O Lord, how man will love it, and wisdom has thou made them all. Give the soul thy affliction, so is this great and white to wear, and our things to be innumerable, and will soft trade thee. There go the ships, there is that life, and thou hast made to play therein. We wait all upon thee, that thou might give them the heat of the season. That thou give us them to gather, thou openest thy hand, they are full of good. Thou hidest thy face, they are troubled, thou takest away their breath, and thine return to their dust. Thou sendest forth thy spirit, they are created, and thou renewest the face of the earth. The glory of the Lord shall endure forever, the Lord shall rejoice in his work. Look at on earth, and in trouble, protect the health of his soul. I will sing unto the Lord as long as I live, I will praise my God, I will have my peace. My meditation is going to be, I will die in the Lord. Thou hast sent a Jesus to God, we are much to be no more. Let thou, the Lord, my soul, praise to the Lord. The sun knows it's going down. Thou make us a darkness in the night, O Lord, how man will love it worth, and wisdom has thou made it all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, O God, cover in us wages of ages, amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, and for the state of the holy churches of God, and union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who have paid reverence in the fear of God and to their end, Father Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy of the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the present United States and all civil authorities and armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for helpful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and suffering, for the captives and their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, we have of us never Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Exodus.
Let us again.
Thus the Lord uses to speak to Moses face to face as a man speaks to his friend. When Moses turned again into the camp, his servant Joshua, the son of Nun, a young man, did not depart from the tent. Moses said to the Lord, "See, thou sayest to me, bring up this people, but thou hast not let me know whom thou wilt send with me. Yet thou hast said, I know you by name, and you have also found favor in my sight. Now therefore I pray thee, if I have found favor in thy sight, show me now thy ways, that I may know thee and find favor in thy sight. Consider too that this nation is thy people." And he said, "My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest." And he said to him, "If thy presence will not go with me, do not carry us up from here. For how shall it be known that I have found favor in thy sight, I and thy people? Is it not in thy going with us, so that we are distinct, I and thy people, from all the other people that are upon the face of the earth?" And the Lord said to Moses, "This very thing you have spoken I will do. For you have found favor in my sight, and I know you by name." Moses said, "I pray thee, show me thy glory." And he said, "I will make all my goodness pass before you, and I will proclaim before you my name, the Lord. And I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and I will show mercy on whom I will show mercy." But he said, "You cannot see my face, for man shall not see me and live." And the Lord said, "Behold, there is a place by me where you shall stand upon a rock, and while my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft of rock, and I will cover you with my hand until I have passed by. Then I will take my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face shall not be seen."
Let us attend.
We shall mindful of the Lord, attend their threat with me. They reward me evil for good.
Wisdom.
Read from the book of Job.
Let us attend.
And the Lord brought the latter days of Job, born in his beginning. He had 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, and 1,000 she asses. He also had 7 sons and 3 daughters. And he called the name of the first Jehovah. And the name of the third, Karen-Hapuch. And in all those days there were no women so fair as Job's daughters. And their father gave them inheritance among their brothers. And after this, Job lived 140 years and saw his sons and his sons' sons 4 generations. And Job died an old man and full of days.
Let us attend.
O Lord, our Lord, God, who lives thy name in all the earth. God, magnificence is elevated above the heavens.
Wisdom.
The reading from the prophecy of Isaiah.
Let us attend.
Behold, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up, and shall be very high. As many were astonished at him, his appearance was so marred beyond the human semblance, and his form beyond that of the sons of men. So shall he startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. For that which has not been told them they shall see, and that which they have not heard they shall understand. Who has believed what we have heard, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or comeliness that we should look at him, and no beauty that we should desire in him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And as one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that made us whole, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray, we have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, and yet he opened not his mouth. Like the lamb that is led to slaughter, and like the sheep that before its shearers is dumb, so he opens not his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away, and asked of his generation, who considered that he was cut off of the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. And they made his grave with the wicked, and with the rich man in his death, although he had done no violence, and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to bruise him. He has put him to grief. When he makes himself an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring. He shall prolong his days, the will of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. He shall see the fruit of the travail of his soul and be satisfied. By his knowledge shall the righteous one, my servant, make amends to be accounted righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore, the portion with the brave, and he shall divide the spoil of the strong. Because he poured out his soul to death, and was numbered with the transgressors, yet he bore the sin of many, and made intercession for the transgressors. Seeing a barren wife who did not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud, you who have not been in travail. For the children of the desolate one will be more than the children of her that is married, says the Lord.
Let us attend.
Then bring me, O Lord, that's in the dark places, O Lord God of my salvation.
I have cried this night before thee. The reading is from the first epistle of St. Paul to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, the word of the cross is folly to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the cleverness of the clever I will thwart. Where is the wise man? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, it pleased God through the folly of what we preach to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs and Greeks seek wisdom, but we preach Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and folly to Gentiles. But to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. For consider your call, brethren, not many of you were wise according to worldly standards. Not many were powerful, not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, even things that are not, to bring to nothing things that are, so that no human might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, whom God made our wisdom, our righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption. Therefore, as it is written, let him who boasts, boast of the Lord. When I came to you, brethren, I did not come proclaiming to you the testimony of God in lofty words of wisdom. For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. And to thy spirit.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom attend, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
Thy Spirit.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend.
At that time, all the chief priests and the elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death, and they bound him and led him away and delivered him to Pontius Pilate. When Judas, his betrayer, saw that Jesus was condemned, he repented and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and the elders, saying, I have sinned in betraying innocent blood. They said, what is that to us? See to it yourself. And throwing down the pieces of silver in the temple, he departed and went and hanged himself. But the chief priests, taking the pieces of silver, said, it is not lawful to put them into the treasury, since they are blood money. So they took counsel and bought with them the potter's field to bury strangers in. Therefore that field has been called the field of blood to this day. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken by the prophet Jeremiah, saying, and they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of him who was valued by the sons of Israel, and they gave them for the potter's field as the Lord directed me. Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, are you the king of the Jews? Jesus said, you have said so. But when Jesus was accused by the chief priests and the elders, he made no answer. Then Pilate said to him, do you not hear how many things they testify against you? But he gave him no answer, not even to a single charge, so that the governor wondered greatly. Now at the feast, the governor was accustomed to release for the crowd any one prisoner whom they wanted, and they had them a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when they had gathered, Pilate said to them, whom do you want me to release for you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called the Christ? For Pilate knew that they had delivered Jesus up out of envy. Besides, while he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him, saying, have nothing to do with that righteous man, for I have suffered much over him today in a dream. Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the people to ask for Barabbas and destroy Jesus. The governor again said to them, "Which of the two do you want me to release for you?" They said, "Barabbas." Pilate said to them, "Then what shall I do with Jesus, who is called Christ?" They all said, "Let him be crucified." And Pilate said, "Why? What evil has he done?" But they shouted all the more, "Let him be crucified." So when Pilate saw that he was gaining nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying, "I am innocent of this righteous man's blood. See to it yourselves." And all the people answered, "His blood be on us and on our children." Then Pilate released for them Barabbas, and having scourged Jesus, delivered him to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the praetorium, and they gathered the whole battalion before him. And they stripped him, and put a scarlet robe upon him, and plaiting a crown of thorns, they put it on his head, and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they spat upon him, and took the reed, and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe, and put his own clothes on him, and led him away to crucify him. As they went out, they came upon a man of Cyrene, Simon by name. This man they compelled to carry Jesus' cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull, they offered him wine to drink, mingled with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his garments among them by casting lots, that what was spoken by the prophet might be fulfilled. They parted my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots. Then they sat down and kept watch over him there. And over his head they put the charge against him, which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two robbers were crucified with him, one on the right and one on the left. One of the criminals who was hanging railed at him, saying, "If you are the Christ, save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we are receiving the due reward of our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." And he said to Jesus, "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus said to him, "Truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." And those who passed by derided him, wagging their heads and saying, "You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down now from the cross." Also the chief priests with the scribes and elders mocked him, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. If he is the King of Israel, let him come down now from the cross, and we will believe in him. He trusts in God, let God deliver him now if he desires him. For he said, 'I am the Son of God.'" And the robbers who were crucified with him also reviled him in the same way. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land until the ninth hour. And at about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani," that is, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" And some of the bystanders, hearing it, said, "This man is calling Elijah." And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled it with vinegar, and put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." And Jesus cried again with a loud voice, and gave up the spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom, and the earth shook, and the rocks were split, the tombs were opened, and the bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. And coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those who were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what had taken place, they were filled with awe and said, "Truly, this was the Son of God." Since it was the day of preparation, in order to prevent the bodies from remaining on the cross on the Sabbath, for that Sabbath was a high day, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and of the other who had been crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once there came out blood and water. He who saw it has borne witness. His testimony is true, and he knows that he tells the truth, that you may also believe. For these things took place that the scripture might be fulfilled, "Not a bone of him shall be broken." And again another scripture says, they shall look upon him whom they have pierced. There were also many women there looking on from afar, who had followed Jesus in Galilee, ministering to him. Among those were Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea, named Joseph, who also was a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered it to be given to him, and Joseph took the body and wrapped it in clean linen shroud and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn in the rock. And he rolled a great stone to the door of the tomb and departed. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were there, sitting opposite the sepulchre.
Glory to the long-suffering Lord, glory to thee.
Let us say with all our soul and with all our mind, let us say, God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for all pious and orthodox Christians, for Father Metropolitan Joseph, for brethren, the priests, deacons, and monks, for all our brotherhood in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation, and pardon and remission of sins for the servants of God, all Orthodox Christians of true worship who live and dwell in this community.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable founders of this holy church, for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox departed this life before us who here, and in all the world last sleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for those who bear fruit and do good works in this holy and all-venerable church, for those who serve and those who sing, for all the people here present, write thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For thou art a merciful God, and lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Let us commit ourselves and each other
Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For thou art the good God and lovest mankind, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
Let us bow our heads to the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
Lord our God, who didst bow the heavens and come down for the salvation of mankind, put upon thy servants and thy inheritance from thee, the fearful judge, we have lovest mankind, and thy servants bow their heads and submissively incline their necks, awaiting not help from men, but entreating thy mercy, and looking confidently for thy salvation. Guard them at all times, both during this present deeply and in the approaching night, from every foe, from all adverse powers of the devil, and from vain thoughts, and from evil imaginations.
Blessed and glorified be the majesty of thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
a light to light the Gentiles and the glory of our people Israel. Holy God, Holy Mighty,
Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O most Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, cleanse us from our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.